Welcome back. In this video, we will focus on the shape of graphs of polynomial functions. In practice, you will most often work with polynomials of degree 2 and lower. Let us look at those separately. The easiest non-zero polynomial functions are those of degree 0. Is that possible? Yes, we can write these functions as f of x equals a times x to the power 0. Now, remember that x to the power 0 is equal to 1. So these are just constant functions. The graphs of these functions are simply horizontal lines. Let's make this a little bit more exciting by passing to degree 1. Degree 1 polynomials have the form f of x equals a times x plus b, where a and b are constant numbers and a is non-zero. The graph of a degree 1 polynomial function is a straight line. That is why these functions are also called linear functions. By the way, also constant functions are examples of linear functions. If you consider the graph, the coefficients a and b actually have a meaning. A represents the increase of the function value if x increases by 1. As such, it is a measure for the steepness of the graph, called the slope. B is precisely the height of the intersection point of the graph and the vertical axis. It is called the y-intercept. For example, let's look at the graph of the linear function f of x equals minus 1 half x plus 2. And indeed you see from the graph that the slope is minus 1 half and the y-intercept equals 2. It is surprising how many dependencies between everyday quantities can be modeled by linear functions. You will see examples of such dependencies in the exercises. Okay, let's go one degree up to functions of degree 2. These functions are called quadratic functions. Quadratic functions also occur in many applications. For example, if you throw a ball, both the height as function of time and the trajectory of the ball can be well described by a quadratic function. A very different example is a suspension bridge, such as the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco. If the cables are much lighter than the deck they carry, the shape of the cables between the pillars can be approximated by a quadratic function. The standard form of a quadratic function is f of x equals a times x squared plus b times x plus c, where a, b and c are numbers. Let's have a look at the graph of such functions. The shape of the graph of any quadratic function is a parabola. It has precisely one extremum, called the vertex, and it is symmetric in the vertical line through this vertex. The relation between the coefficients a, b and c of the polynomial on the one hand and the shape of the graph on the other hand is not as clear as in the case of linear functions. However, we can at least say the following. A is a measure for the wideness and orientation of the parabola. If A is positive, the parabola opens upward. If it is negative, it opens downward. Also, the closer A to zero, the wider the parabola is. Furthermore, the x-coordinate of the vertex of the parabola is located at x is equal to minus b divided by 2a. And finally, c gives the y-intercept of the graph. Let me show you an example. F of x equals 1 half times x squared minus 3 times x plus 5 over 2. Indeed, you see that the graph opens upward. The x-coordinate of the vertex equals minus b over 2a and the y-intercept equals the constant term. As we mentioned, you can write any polynomial in standard form. But when it comes to quadratic polynomials, there are at least two other forms that are also very useful. The first is the factorized form, a times x minus p times x minus q, where a, p and q are numbers. The advantage of this form is that it tells you a lot about the shape of the graph. A gives information about the wideness of the parabola and whether it opens upward or downward, just as before. P and Q are precisely the x-coordinates of intersection points with the horizontal axis. The polynomial function in our example can be rewritten as 1 half times x minus 1 times x minus 5. And indeed, you see that the graph intersects the horizontal axis in x equal to 1 and x equal to 5. Another common form is the complete square form, a times x minus r squared plus s, where a, r and s are numbers. Here, a plays the same role as before. But also r and s have a clear interpretation. They are the x and y coordinate of the vertex. Our example polynomial can also be written in this form: 1 half times x minus 3 squared minus 2. And indeed, you see that the vertex is located at 3, minus 2. What about polynomial functions of higher degree? Of course, there's always a relation between the coefficients and the shape of the graph. But this relation becomes more complicated and obscure the higher the degree gets. We can say some general things, though. It turns out that the degree is a measure of how complicated the polynomial function and its graph can be. In fact, the following is true. If you look at the graph of a polynomial function of degree n, then it will intersect the horizontal axis in n points or fewer. The only exception is the polynomial, which is constantly equal to zero. For example, the graph of a degree 4 polynomial function may intersect the horizontal axis in 4 points, or in less than 4 points, but never more than 4. Intuitively, you can think of it as follows. The higher the degree, the more wobbly the graph may look. Since you will encounter polynomial functions in many contexts, especially linear and quadratic functions, it is important to get a feeling for the relation between a polynomial and the shape of its graph. The exercises that follow this video will give you the opportunity to practice this. Good luck!